Let's talk about clock rate and sync source on your Behringer Wing. Now, clock rate is the sample rate at which your mixer operates at. Now, the Behringer Wing has to operate at a specific frequency. It can either be at 48,000 hertz or 44.1 kilohertz. Now, the main difference between 44.1 and 48K is that 44.1 kilohertz was made for CD recordings. So if your final destination is your band to end up on a CD as your only platform, then I would suggest setting your console to 44.1 kilohertz. That way you are recording in the same sample rate that you are going to be ending in your destination at. Now, if you're doing anything else, I would always recommend running your console at 48 kilohertz. In fact, if you are recording and plan on releasing on some digital platforms and CDs, I would still recommend 48 kilohertz, as this is going to give you the most resolution for your audio. Now, all devices that are connected into the Behringer Wing will have to be the same sample rate. So you can't plug in, say, a Midas DL251 running at 96K into your Behringer Wing and expect it to work. It will need to be set to the same sample rate as your Behringer Wing, which in this case can either be 48 kilohertz or 44.1. kilohertz. Now, the next thing is our sync source. Now, one sync has to be the master, meaning that if you have a single Behringer Wing and a single stage box, that stage box is going to be taking its sample rate or its clock source from your Behringer Wing, in which case we would want to set it to internal. Now, say you had multiple consoles on your AES50 network. Well, then I would choose one of those consoles to be the master for your sync. And then all of the rest of them are going to be pulling in their sync directly from that one console. So say you had a Behringer Wing at front of house and an AES50 stage box and a monitor console, that maybe the monitor console is connected on the AES50B. I would make sure that the Wing is the internal master, and then the other monitor console would be pulling its clock source from the Wing. Now, the available clock sources that we have for our Behringer Wing is internal AES50A, B, and C. We have AES-EBU, which is talking about that little XLR digital connection on the back of the Wing. We also have module as well as the expansion card. Now, speaking of the expansion card, if you are using a Dante module, I would suggest letting the Dante module be the clock source for the entire network. That way, your Behringer Wing can be pulling its clock from that Dante card, the Dante network can be pulling its clock sync source from that Dante card, and then the rest of the devices are also synced to that one Dante card. That will give you the least amount of pops and drops.